good morning. Right to the right for Apple and share, bottom to the top for Android and share. Big share it Friday, Friday, Freedom Friday.
When you're on the top, there's no place you can really go but down, down.
Good morning,
down.
Good morning, everybody. Come on in, let's share. Everybody that's present. I need you to share this life. So we're going to start here in the next couple of minutes. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Cheryl. Good morning. That's what you're listening to. Hey, Pastor, how you doing? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Turn off the temptation. Who's next after the temptation? All right. Thank you very much for sharing. Welcome. Put your name in what city you're from. And share. Let's go. All right. Let's go. Let's get this party started. Turn the music off. Turn the screen around. Pensacola, Florida. All right. Welcome, you guys. All right. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Daryl Muhammad here from Houston, Texas, coming to you live from my home office. Real estate investor, mentor, coach. Just an entrepreneur. Former stockbroker, networker, network marketer, sales and marketing professional. On and on, off and online marketing. Brothers and sisters, just here with you today. Today is Friday, February 26th. Happy Savior's Day to those who know what I'm talking about. Happy Savior's Day. We're excited to be here with you. Why? Because today is Freedom Friday. On Fridays, we talk about freedom. We talk about financial freedom. We talk about freeing ourselves from those things that are stopping us from living the financial reality and the financial life that we desire and we believe God has desired for us as well, all right? To free us from those myths and misconceptions that you have to choose poverty or choose God. That's not what we believe here at the Money Game. That's not what I believe, and I hope that's not what you believe. Punta or Obama, God, and you just got blocked, all right? So, brothers and sisters, welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Daryl Muhammad. Need for you to share. Brothers and sisters, need for you to share. Go ahead and share it because we need to spread this message. We need to excite ourselves and our community about the money game and how to play the money game to win and what rules we have to play by in order to win. Good morning, Living Chic. Good morning, Living Chic over there at Meerkat. Brothers and sisters, if you want to follow me, if you want to connect with me, here's how you do it. You go to DarylMuhammad.net. All right, that's my blog. Hit one of the blog posts and subscribe. That'll put you on a special VIP list because we're going to start having more and more live events. We're going to have one this Sunday at 7:30. So you're going to get that information emailed to you here in the next 48 hours, how to participate on that live event. It's going to be a meetup group where you come on the conference call and introduce yourself and tell us about you and your business, all right, or what you plan to do to empower yourself, your family, but most importantly, the black community. That's an opportunity for us to connect, brothers and sisters, so we can move forward and do some pretty amazing things in our community. Thank you, Sister Niambi. That is where you need to go, to DarylMuhammad.net, and subscribe. Now, if you want to reach me on any of the social medias, it's my name, Daryl Muhammad. That's on Periscope, Twitter, Facebook is Daryl Muhammad fan page, and on Snapchat is Daryl Muhammad, all right? Start meeting me over there, Snapchat, brothers and sisters. You got to get ahead of the curve, not behind the curve. And Snapchat, as has been said, and I am tend to believe, oh, how you do that? Tend to believe that it will be, you know, the wave of the future for marketers and another place to socialize and meet and spread your message. All right. So with that being said, welcome, welcome, welcome everybody to Friday's edition of the Money Game, where you learn how to play the money game by the rules to win and not by default, the rules to lose. And today is Freedom Friday. All right. We have themes for 3 days of the week. All right. Well, good for you. For 3 days of the week. All right, is that Sister Amina? All right, so 3 days of the week. All right, so we're going to answer all those questions, but go ahead and share Amina. Thank you, Sister. Good to see you. Thanks for being here. All right, so for every day, 3 days a week, we have a theme. Monday is going to be Monday Mindset, dealing with financial empowerment of the mind. And Wednesday is question and answers, and today is Financial Freedom Friday or Freedom Friday. And we just want to just put a dialogue out there, start talking about, thinking about freedom more than money. Freedom more than money. Because you can have money and don't have freedom. You can have freedom and don't have money. Yes, you can. It's going to be very difficult, but I believe it can be done, right? It can be done. But, you know, why not have both? Why not have freedom and money? Why not have freedom and money? That's the best of both worlds. They call that financial freedom. They call that financial freedom. You're free to do what you want to do, when you want to do it, who you want to do it with, and you have the money to do it. All right? And you have the money to do it. So, that's my ultimate goal. I hope that's your ultimate goal of financial freedom. So, brothers and sisters, you know, we as black people here in America, that's why you see those hashtags, hashtag black dollars, hashtag black economy, hashtag black wealth, because this stream is about black empowerment, all right? You know, for those that are on here that's not black, you have to, you know, you all need to mature and grow up and understand for one thing doesn't mean you're automatically against something else. So just because we're hashtagging black don't mean it's a hashtag anti-white. All right. So grow up and, you know, grow up because things are moving on. Life is moving on. Society is moving on. and we are getting left behind. You are getting left behind just entertaining the thought and let alone expressing it. Because we're on a pathway, brothers and sisters. We're on a pathway of freedom, right? You see it around the world. People are pursuing freedom. People are tired of being at the bottom, being stepped on, and they're pressing themselves up towards freedom. And anybody that's holding them back, anybody that's in the way, is going to get stepped on, is going to get crunched, right? And that's what we have to understand about the financial freedom pursuit and the money game. The money game is non-emotional. The money game is not, you know, highly sensitive, ultra sensitive. You're overly sensitive about, you know, everybody's opinions and how they feel. There's no way for us to be free as a people or financially free being concerned with how other people feel. As long as your intention and my intention, brothers and sisters, is not malicious, is not evil spirited, then we are not to be concerned about those who differ from us, right? And the truth of the matter is, it really says more about them than it says about us, and it lets us know what their position is and how we should position them in our pursuit for freedom, our pursuit for financial freedom, all right? Because the same obstacles you're going to get for financial freedom, you're going to get for social freedom. You're going to get those same obstacles. You're going to get people that's going to ask you, why? What are you doing? What's wrong? What about us? Does that mean you're against this? Does that mean you're against that? Right? You have to understand that's the dynamics of people's psyche being expressed to you. And that's good. Because the worst thing that can happen in your pursuit of freedom of any kind, brothers and sisters, is for us not to know who people are. Right? Not to know who people are, the people that's around us, not to know what position they take. That's why there's categories. Are you a Republican? Are you a Democrat? Are you a Tea Party? Are you independent? Right? Are you a Muslim? Are you a Christian? Are you a Pan-Africanist? It's so that people can identify and people can know where you stand, what position you're taking in life. All right? So let us understand the dynamics in our pursuit of financial freedom and our pursuit of social freedom. Because if there's somebody that's being freed from something, then that means there's a force that's preventing us from being freed. Okay? And they can't want you to be free if they're preventing you from being free. Talking about the forces. Right? Now you have to identify what those forces are for you. There's always two forces, internal forces and external forces. And the biggest one we have to overcome is internal. Too often we spend time on external forces and we don't deal with the internal forces. Okay? Because if we take care of the enemy within, there's a saying that goes something like this. If I can overcome the enemy in me, there's no enemy outside of me that can do me any harm. Okay? So we have to have the discipline, brothers and sisters, of freedom. We have to have the focus of freedom. We have to have the determination of freedom. And in that pursuit, we will become financially free. In that pursuit, we will be no longer concerned about, you know, our internal desires or external influence. And I say internal desires, I mean the natural desires of things, right? We'll be able to sacrifice. We'll be able to fight sleep in order to continue to focus and do what's necessary for financial freedom. We won't eat. Right. We won't have to every time, you know, we get involved or every time we didn't get engaged, we automatically got to go use the restroom. We automatically got to go get some water. Just things to interrupt the momentum. These are internal enemies that we have to break. Right. These internal enemies that we have to break. So that's what that's about. We're talking about today Financial Freedom Friday, or we're talking about freedom. See, if we can crystallize the very basic of things, then we can build on those levels. We can build on the basic understanding of things and get into more of the sophistication of things. If we can understand the just the pure essence and requirements and dynamics of freedom, then now we can apply that to educational freedom, social freedom, financial freedom, right? Cultural freedom. So then we'll be able to do that. But so often we start on the fringes. We start with the social freedom, not understanding what's required for freedom, right? And those that understand, such as the Jewish people, right? And I'm not talking about biblical Jewish people. I'm talking about contemporary Jewish people back in the 40s with Hitler. Okay, you're talking about other people who have actually gone through the process of becoming free. Becoming free. Now, the different and unique thing about black people than other people around the world is that we were given our freedom. We fought for freedom. Yes, of course, you know, if you know your own history, we fought for freedom, but we were given freedom. Right? It was given to us. And true freedom is never given to you. True freedom you earn, you take. Right? All right? So if I go out there, you go out there and you earn financial freedom, is not the same as if someone that wins the Powerball. It's not the same. That's why those who win the Powerball lose all their money within 5 years. And those that who earn or become financially free of their own efforts, right? Even if they lose it, they get it back, right? They get it back again. That has happened time and time and time again because it wasn't given to them. They earned it. They deserved it. They worked hard for it. See, we have to understand those, that's the process of becoming free, of you being the catalyst for your freedom, not somebody else being the catalyst for your freedom, not somebody else saying, we're going to give you integration. Okay? So same thing with it is financially, brother. So go ahead and share this stream. I don't know how many black folks get on live streams and talk about freedom. Now, we'll get on here and talk about police brutality and you know, and how they're, you know, killing us in the hospitals and all that kind of stuff. But when you talk about freedom, we talk about civil rights. That's not the same thing as freedom. See, civil rights is a law that is written, that is given to you. And if somebody can write a law to give you something, they can write a law to take it away. But freedom is God-given right that he gives to every creature, even animals, have the natural desire to be free. That's why if you go into the wild and you try to catch an animal, they're going to run from you. And if you put them in the cage, you're going to try to get out of the cage. Because it's not normal, it's not natural to be enslaved, it's not natural to be caged in. God put in every creature the desire for freedom. Because when you have freedom, you can express yourself unprohibited. Right? So that's what we're talking about. Here in America, in a developed country, you need money from somewhere. If it's not yours, you need to get it from somewhere in order to express yourself freely. So in case you wanted to play the piano, now you got to go buy a piano or go rent a piano or go take piano lessons. That requires money. If you change your mind, say, well, I thought I wanted to play the piano. I don't want to play the piano anymore, but I just love music so much. Maybe I'll try the guitar. So you go play the guitar. You buy a guitar. You rent a guitar. You go take guitar lessons. See, so your expression requires resources. And the exchange for resources in any developed society is money, is the currency of that country. So to the extent that you want to have and I want to have free expression, we need to understand what role, not all white people are just giving freedom first. Okay, well, good. All right, first, we were all Americans. No, that's not true. That's not true. Save your commentary for the end, and we'll deal with that. But we're talking about financial freedom. We're talking about freedom of black people. All right, that's what we're talking about right now. That's what we're talking about on these scopes. And we're not all Americans, right? We're not all Americans. If you look at the definition of America, the true definition of America, the root, the etymology of the word American, go do your homework, and then you'll find out that we all are not Americans, not original Americans. How about that? Not original Americans. So, brothers and sisters, we're talking about financial freedom. We're talking about being free as a people. And freedom comes first with knowledge. Freedom comes first with the right knowledge. And what is the right knowledge? Because there's right knowledge and there's wrong knowledge. Right knowledge is the knowledge that will free you from that which is keeping you enslaved. Right? Knowledge is that will free you from what's keeping you enslaved. Misconcepts, misinformation, bad data about money, bad data about what to do with money, bad data about how to get money, bad data on how to invest money, bad data if you're talking about freedom as a people, bad data about yourself. Right? Bad data about yourself. Most people are on the surface. Very few people delve down into the depths of anything. That's why Malcolm was so powerful. One of the reasons why Malcolm X was so powerful, because when he was in prison, he read the dictionary. So he understood the etymology of words, whereas we just say words and we go by how it's used and how people around us use words. And its narrow definition of that word. So therefore, we think we know words. Right? And we do know words on a surface level, but we don't know words to the extent of those who know the etymology of the word. The origin of the word. Okay? So we're around here, all Americans. Yeah, okay. Yeah, right. All right. So that's what we have to understand. And see, as that information comes and challenges you, right? You have to have enough depth and mass to push back that misinformation. So as you pursue freedom, as you pursue financial freedom, you'll have people just like that person right there that's going to challenge you, right? They're going to challenge you. They're going to try to water down your message. They're going to try to slow you down and water down your determined pursuit for financial freedom. Right? And you have to be aware of that. You have to know that that's going to exist. So you won't be surprised. Right? The worst thing that can happen is you be surprised. Oh, my goodness. Right? Don't be surprised. You don't entertain all of it because many times they're just pure distractors. That's all they are distractors. Right? And you can't be distracted. Focus is key for freedom, financial freedom. All right? It's key because they will have people, their sole purpose is to distract you. They're doing nothing purposeful with their own lives, so they want to make sure that you become like them. And you don't do anything purposeful with your own life, right? They want you to be like them. Right? They want you to be like them. So, brothers and sisters, we're talking about financial freedom. This is Freedom Friday. Freedom Friday. Black folks have to put their focus back on freedom. Nothing but freedom. Full and complete freedom. Freedom. Freedom, 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 not money. Because too often we sell ourselves for money. For just money, and we have no free time to raise our children, no free time to enjoy our family, no free time to get out and do things because we work, you know, the night shift. So while you up, everybody's sleep. While you sleep, everybody's up. Freedom is about making choices. So whatever choice you want to make in life, brothers and sisters, design your life to create, to allow you to be able to do those things. Here's an assignment, right quick. Here's an assignment. Freedom Friday. Here's an assignment. And go ahead and share it, brothers and sisters. Go ahead and share it. Share, share, share. All right? I need your help. We need to get these counts up to 30 and 40 and 50 and 60 and 70 people on a regular basis. Okay? And I need your help. I need for everybody that's present to share. Right? Everybody that's present to share. That's what this is about. I'm going to start going live on Facebook, and that would help us out as well. I just figured out how to use the how to find the live button on my Apple tablet. So we're going to start doing Periscope, Meerkat, and Facebook Live on these live streams of the Money Game. Okay, so that's going to help because we got to get this message out, brothers and sisters. This is, you know, it's not about rhetoric. You know, I don't like talking heads, and I don't want to be a talking head, right? I don't want to be somebody just talk, you know, and there's nobody joining in on the conversation and nobody here in pursuit with me on this journey of financial freedom and spreading the word in the Black community. Hashtag Black Dollars, hashtag Black Wealth, hashtag Black Economy. Black Economy, right? If I was a motivational speaker, this thing would be blowing up. If I was a minister, this thing would be blowing up, right? If I was talking about whatever that is, Brand, the brother and the psychic and stuff that I saw the other night, see, this thing would be full of 50, 60 people. Brothers and sisters, you have to be a part of the change that you're looking for. If you're just changing and you show up by yourself, then you're not playing the money game to win. You're playing the money game to lose because you're playing by losing rules. You're playing by losing rules. Interesting enough, those that are most successful at winning at the money game have the most friends. The most meaningful friends. They know the most people. Why? Because as Robert Kiyosaki says, you determine your net worth by your network. Your network, right? Your network. That's why it's called network marketing. And that's why we fail so often in network marketing, because we don't have a network. Our network is shallow. It's hard to come up with 100 names because your network is too small. You're not sharing with people, right? You're not sharing with people. We're too, you know, and that's just, I think, is from our condition of slavery, coming out of slavery, right? When we've been programmed to have the mentality of lack, we go from the mentality of lack to the other extreme of greed. And greed is greed because you have more than what you need, and you're trying to get more. That's greed, right? So we go from one extreme to another. So we need to find a happy medium. We need as many people on this stream as that's on talking about the housewives and, you know, talking about all that foolishness, right? This stream is here to galvanize those that want to be the solution, right? And not just another broadcaster of negative news in our community. Because let me tell you something, brothers and sisters. If we understand how to play the money game, if we understand freedom, and if we understand in America, somebody has to finance your freedom. Somebody has to finance your freedom. Who's going to finance your freedom? That's why we're not free as we should be as Black people in America, because we don't finance our own freedom. The NAACP was founded and financed by Jewish people. And they're still the major contributors today. So how free can we be if we have somebody from the outside finance us. That's why Minister Farrakhan said this past Savior's Day that we are a colonial state. Black community is a colony. See, once again, if you learn the etymology of words, no, we're not, we Americans. Black people in America make up a colony. All right, so go look up the word a colony. A colony is one who's being controlled by outside forces. They do not control their own environment. They do not control what happens in their environment. It's an outside force that controls them, and all the resources that the colony has goes out to the ones who are controlling the colony. That's why America had the Tea Party, because it was a colony of England, and all the wealth of America had to go back to England because it was a colony. So black people, you are part of a colony. You and I are members of a colony because we refuse to be free and full and completely free. We got money, but it's going out because we're a colony. We're a colony. Right? So yeah, we Americans. There's yet to be free from our colonial masters. So this is Freedom Friday, brothers and sisters. Freedom Friday. Financial freedom is just one piece of freedom. Right? Financial freedom is just one piece. We have to have freedom of health. We have to have freedom of health. If not, all your money will go to health, trying to stay healthy. Right? So it's all connected. It's all interconnected, brothers and sisters. If you don't have money, you can't eat the best of foods. You get sick. Now you can't get the best of medical attention. Now you die. Right? Now you die. So if you have money, you can buy the best of foods, which will preserve your health, which will minimize your medical expenses to live. Unfortunately, brothers and sisters, here in America, for those who don't have money, it's cheaper to die than it is to live. See, share this message, brother. We're talking about freedom, see? If this was about how to make $1 million in real estate or how to become a six-figure income earner in network marketing in 90 days, this thing would be full. See, to go to show you, everybody don't want freedom. It's only a few who are willing to make the ultimate sacrifice so that all of us can be free. It's only a few that's willing to make the ultimate sacrifice so the rest of us can be free. Those that are scared, those who are misled, those that are ignorant, right? Those that are just whatever, deceived. Do I speak French? No. Right? So that's what we have to understand. We have to understand what is freedom? How do you get it? What do I have to do? What will I persist? What will I have to persist against? What are going to be some of my obstacles internally, externally? And am I up for the task? Be honest with yourself, brothers and sisters. To thy own self be true, as states in the pyramids of Egypt, stolen from by the Greeks. To thy own self be true. So don't lie to yourself. If you can't do it, then that's okay. Doesn't make you a bad person. Just pray that God would strengthen somebody that would do it for the rest of us who can't or won't do it. Because somebody has to do it. Right? Somebody has to do it. And participate. You can play your role. Everybody has a role to play. Sitting on a sideline is not a role to play. You can't afford to sit on the sideline, brothers and sisters, in today. Right? You can't afford to sit on the sideline. sitting on the sideline right now would be the same as you sitting on the sideline during the 60s when our people were out there battling for freedom. Now here it is coming around again. Here it is coming around a second time. Now you and I have an opportunity to go down in history as being a part of those who participated, not once, not twice, but who were constantly engaged. So what can you do? Here's what you can do. Go to www.theablenetwork.com. Put that in there for me, Susan Nyambe, The Able Network. I think that's right. Theablenetwork.com. And buy you some good, healthy food. Don't say you don't have the money. That's what those that lose at the money game say. If you're going to win and play by the rules of the money game, you have to understand that nothing is too expensive for you. Nothing is too expensive for that which you need to fuel your mind and your body and your spirit to win. It's about winning. It's not playing a good game. It's not fighting a good fight. It's about winning, brothers and sisters. It's about winning. Winning. Learn how to win. Winners are addicted to winning, and unfortunately, losers are addicted to losing. So go to theablenetwork.com. Go to freedompapercompany.com. And get you some toilet paper. Wipe your butt with some pride. All right. And go to theeconomicblueprint.org. Right. If you're not part of the solution, brothers and sisters, by default, you're part of the problem. Don't make you a bad person. Just make you part of the problem. OK. Stop. If you're not putting your money where your mouth is, you might as well save your breath for your dying days so you can maybe get a couple of more breaths of life because you saved them because you wasn't around here doing all that talking and didn't put your money where your mouth is. If you're not putting your money where your mouth is in America on a regular and consistent basis, you're not saying nothing. You're just taking up space. So go out there and buy you some toilet paper. Buy a case. Buy you some chicken. All natural chicken. They even genetically modifying the salmon now. You won't be able to eat anything, so you might as well get in the habit now. And fish, right? Chicken, fish, and turkey. Right? The Able Network isn't available in Texas. Yes, it is. I believe it is. All right, brothers and sisters. So we're talking about Freedom Friday, financial freedom. And the first thing you have to free is your mind. Free your mind first and then your pocketbooks. And once your mind is freed, keep it free because you can catch a runaway slave, right? You can catch a runaway slave and put him back in slavery, right? So free your mind, keep it free, and free your pockets. Let your money be the tool you use for financial freedom. See, you don't hear that in the black community. Why? Because those leaders that we have outside of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, in my humble opinion, they're bought and paid for. Right? They're bought and paid for. So they can't tell you about the economic piece. Because those that finance them will lose out if we do economic withdrawal. If we now stop being a colony and start building for ourselves an independent economic base, they will lose out. So they can't do that. The CDC, the Congressional Black Caucus can't do it because they financed, right? Action committee, he can't do it because he's financed by them. They know the game better than you and I know how to play it, brothers and sisters. They've been buying our leaders ever since we've been free. And they pass down that strategy and they use it. But what we passed down, we just passed down the struggle. We just passed down the struggle of holding on to the little stuff that we got instead of trying to go and get more. Right? We try to get the foot off our neck instead of to cut the damn foot that's on our neck. Just cut the foot off. See, it's a whole new day now, brothers. So we can't continue to play these 60 games. We're playing games with by the 60 rules, and they playing the game by the 21st century rules. They playing 2016 rules. We playing 1964 civil rights rules, and we're wondering why we losing. You're supposed to lose. You using plays that they played in the Super Bowl back in 1960s, and you playing against a defense that got the defense of the 2016. You're not supposed to win. Matter of fact, supposed to get slaughtered, and we getting slaughtered. Because we playing by these old rules. I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, it's this economic peace. It's the economic peace that we have to play by. We have to play the game and play by the rules to win. Do that by pooling your resources and being independent. It's better for you and I to be what? Multi-millionaires and independent than to be a billionaire and be a slave. See, because you got to understand at some point in time, it's all relevant. Once you get to a certain level of financial freedom, it's all relevant. If I'm a multimillionaire, I mean, all Warren Buffett can do is just buy more of what I can buy. You don't need more. He only can buy more Rolls Royces, buy a bigger luxury lot, a yacht. I mean, so what's the point? Right? What's the point, brothers and sisters? So we're talking about financial freedom Friday, financial freedom Friday. So that's my rant for today on freedom. I hope you watch the replay and share it. You can share it and show hearts doing a replay. Go to DarylMuhammad.net. We're going to have another meet and greet this Sunday at 7:30. And it's only for those that are on the VIP list. So go to DarylMuhammad.net. And that's where you can, thank you, Suniyama. That's where you can, you'll get the call-in number. And you'll be able to introduce yourself, tell us what business you're in, and tell us what you're going to do to help you, your family, but most importantly, the black community. It's about networking. If you're not on social media to network, then you're on to socialize, and that's okay too. But if you're in business or you have a purpose in life that you believe God has shown you, then you should be on there to network as well. Network as well. Social media. You can use it to network around the world like we're doing here. You don't associate with white people too. Well, what I'm saying, you don't associate with white people. I don't understand that question. Ask that question again. I'm not understanding what you're asking. So if you have any questions, brothers and sisters, just go ahead and ask your question right now. I'll hang around here for about 5 minutes. We only like to go about 20 minutes in content through this. Ask your question in totality again so I can understand it. But anyway, so 20 minutes. What can white people join in your cause? Yeah, of course you can. But here's what I would do if I was a white person. I'll go to other white people and find white people who want to help in our cause. And you all get together and you all deal with that side of the equation. Right? You all deal with white people who are sympathetic to our cause. And then you go to your politicians, you go to your business people, and then you go there and you do what you can to make it better for us. They are everywhere. Father Flager does. I know what Father Flager does. Yeah, absolutely. All right. So that's what you should do. All right. Because, you know, we have to do what we have to do, and we have to be left alone to do what we have to do. Right. You know, we would like your help. We don't need your help. We only need the help of God and each other. But if you want to help, then that's how you help, right? That's how you help. Here in the Woodlands, in our office, we have more blacks than whites. It's about being one, sir, ma'am, whoever you are. All right? But like I said, go over there to your people and talk to your people about that, right? I'm not really concerned about you talking to me about that. You white folks cannot, white folks do not know the plight of black people better than black people. So to come on here and try to, you know, espouse your position and your opinion, you know, I mean, what's the point? Go talk to your people, get them to understand. See, I don't need to understand your position. I need to understand and be clear on my position and stand firm on my position and our position. And you need to go to your people and get them to understand. Because, see, we're not the biggest deterrent of our success. We are. Yes, we are. You're a little, yeah, you're a lot confused. Where's my hostility come from? Sir, I'm about to block you because you're not understanding. You're too defensive. See, if one is defensive, you know, you see, white folks can see, white folks don't understand the spirit of black people. That's why we have to be left alone to do our work for ourselves, because true independence comes, like I said, from internal. It doesn't come from people on the outside trying to impose their mentality on you. All right. Yes, you are confused. You are very confused. See, you confuse the spirit of black people, their charisma, their passion, their language as being upset. Right? See, black folks are not confused with this spirit. They don't see this spirit as being a spirit of being hostile, being upset. See, that's in your mind. That says more about you than it says about me, but you're trying to impose your concept. Oh yeah, see, that's the problem. You think black people are just fine. sir, you know, I'm going to block you, but you need to move on because you're more of a distraction than a construction. Yeah, you're imposing. Anytime you push yourself, your views on someone, that's called imposing. Imposing. Imposition. What did I even do, dude? You're not listening. That's what you're doing. You're not listening. See, it's like this. If I went into a Chinese community and said I wanted to help you, help the Chinese community, I'm going to go in and listen. Listen and understand from their perspective what they're dealing with. I'm not going to go in, and this is probably your first time on the stream, I'm not going to go in on a first meeting and start telling, well, you know, it's like this. Well, you know, it's like that. I'm coming into their community, into their space, into their environment. Even though it says it's an open door, that lets you know right there they welcome you if it's an open door. But I'm going to go into a Chinese community based on my limited understanding of their culture and their struggle, and I'm going to start telling them, you know, what I feel and what I think. Hey, what's up over there? It's gotta be Junior. All right, so, you know, it's just very interesting. That's part of the problem, and that's why we have to come together and do whatever. Misunderstood me. Thanks a lot for being rude. No, I tell you what. All right. So, yeah. So that's what we do, brothers and sisters. See, that's a good example. See, when you talk strong black like Beyonce, man, I mean, it's just twisted. Right. So that's why we're in the condition we're in, because a lot of black people don't have the testicle fortitude to persist against that kind of rhetoric. So what most of us do, because we're coming out of slavery and we want to be so close to the same slave master and his society, to where we'll withdraw, right? We won't be so black. We won't talk so black. We'll talk black, you know, with black folks, but we won't talk so black publicly. That's why I love George Frazier. Check out George Frazier, one of his books right here. George Frazier, right? 40, been on the journey for 40 years. And he pro-black. He says black. He down with black. He gonna tell you black. Black, 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 black. Claude Anderson. Get his book. Go to DarylMuhammad.net. Hit more. Hit book list and order and get his Black Labor, White Wealth. He's black. Right? If you don't like symphony music, why are you staying in the symphony hall and then you want to talk to the people next to you complaining about the music? Leave the hall. And if you call too much of the services, the ushers will come and get you and take you out. Black Labor, White Wealth. Right? So brothers and sisters, it's not time to be weak. It's time to be strong. It's time to look at your coworkers. You know, if they want to engage in the conversation, you know, it's up. I don't entertain them, to be honest with you, because you're going to get more of that. You know, Father Flagger is one of millions, right? And I'm not going to waste my time looking for one out of the million. They will surface and they will show their own face. All right. Any questions? Let's get back on top. But all of that was topic. That's topic. See, because that's what you're going to face, brothers and sisters, in the financial realm, the financial freedom realm. Yeah, I don't know. You shouldn't invest in that. You shouldn't start that business. Well, you know, I knew somebody lost money. And well, what about, you know, why are you going to open up in the Black community? Why don't you go somewhere where everybody can patronize you? You know, money is green. Right? So how are you going to deal with that? Are you going to buckle because you're not rooted in your resolve, in your determination? Right? So you have to understand the mindset that you're going to have to deal with. If it says hashtag black dollar, hashtag black wealth, hashtag black economy, and you white and you get on here, what does that say about you? I'm not saying good or bad. I'm just asking a question, right? What would draw a white person to a live stream that says hashtag black everything? And not just listen, but participate. See, trying to deter our direction. And that's happened too often, too many times. But those days are over, brothers and sisters, for me. I want to be one of those voices. I'm looking for Nat Turner's. I'm looking for Harriet Tubman's, right? I'm looking, absolutely, sister, right? I'm looking for those that are freedom fighters, right? Because it's very disingenuous for us as Black people to take advantage of the benefits that those before us has laid, but we're not willing to pick up the banner and carry it ourselves. That's why we're losing progress, because it's very disingenuous of us as Black people to take advantage of all the progress of our brothers and sisters that bled, died, and went to jail. And then here, you don't even want to participate. You don't even want to buy Black. You don't even want to make a commitment to support your own. Then you don't deserve to be free. You deserve to lose your freedom that you got if you're that disingenuous and that disrespectful of your forefathers. Why you think the American society put so much emphasis on the President's Day? Right? Why you think the politicians talk so much about the Constitution and the forefathers? They're paying respect and honor, and they're keeping themselves focused on what has gotten them to the place that they are today. Then they argue between themselves, among themselves about it, but the fact of the matter is they're reminded of it. We're too forgetful. We forget everything. We remember how, you know, how this person treated you wrong, but we forget those who've treated us right. And we don't live in their honor. We live in our own honor. We live to get honor. We live for respect. You won't get what you don't put out, brothers and sisters. That is a rule that you have to play by if you plan on winning at the money game. We're talking about freedom. And thank God for whoever that was, because it came right on in on the right day, because we're talking about freedom. And that's exactly what we have to free ourselves of. But you have to free yourself up here first. You have to free yourself of being concerned about anybody that's trying to detract you, get you off course, water you down. Oh yeah, this world can't handle Black. It can't handle Black. See, you got to understand that, brothers and sisters. It can't handle Black. Black is an eliminator. Right? So yeah, he's supposed to be scared. It's natural to be scared. It's natural for you to think it's hostility, it's anger. Yeah, you should. Yeah, yeah, that's your perspective. But black folks see it as love. Black folks see it as compassion. Black folks see it as strength in the midst of weakness. And if you and I don't see it the same way, then that means you and I don't have the same mind. When I first got to law school, I toned it down because I was so uncomfortable and it took some time to undo that thinking. Yeah, brother. Well, you know, higher education is designed to tone you down. Higher education is designed to make you prepare you for assimilation into society. That's what it is. And that's why we have to be smart today. Right? We have to be smart. There's two wars. There's an overt war and a covert war. And I used to tell my supporters when we was going to the Million Man March, I used to tell them, I said, you know what? You have to be as wise as our enemy. Right? Our enemy, if he's not willing to go out in public to take a particular stance, because it might be jeopardizing to him and his family. He's wise enough. What? He's wise enough to finance you going. I say President Bush would never send his children to war, but he got enough sense to finance to send your children to war. So if I'm willing enough to put on the uniform, if I'm willing enough to come on these live streams and become a target, then those of you who are scared should have at least enough sense to finance me, to finance us. To go to DarylMuhammad.net and hit more and hit that book list and buy you about $2,000-$3,000 worth of books. See, our enemy works better than us. See, we either have those in the forefront, overt operation, and then we have little or nobody on the covert side. But let me tell you this. Our enemy, his covert operation is financed by businesses. His covert operation is financed by businesses. The Koch brothers, K-O-C-H. Go Google them. You'll find out what I'm talking about. Until we as black business people, we as black entrepreneurs start playing like that, then we'll never win. The businesses are in the background financing those organizations that are overt and out in the public. That's the game. That's the rule that you have to play by if you want to win at the money game. And you can play at the level that you're at now, brothers and sisters. You don't have to say, wait till I get my income tax check. You don't have to say, wait till I get my next paycheck. You don't have to wait till I pay off my next bills. You're going to wait till you die. That's what's going to happen. Go to economicblueprint.org and put your pennies there. God can multiply a penny. But you don't have a penny worth of faith. If you had a dollar worth of faith, you'd give a dollar. Right? Faith the size of a mustard seed, brother says. If there's no questions, that takes us to the top of the hour. And I'm so happy to have you here. So happy that you stuck around. And I'm just going to go harder and harder and harder and harder. Because my leader and my teacher, he's going hard at 82 years old. I got 31 more years to get to that point, God willing. So I can't be tired right now. I'm going to go Facebook Live because, you know, you got to have as many voices. Brothers and sisters, if you got this voice, then you get on it. Sister Denise is on it. Sister Denise is on it. Sister Denise is on it, all right? We need to get as many of these voices out here as possible. We need to make sure that our people understand the time. And as Gary Vanderchuk says, right? He says you have to market in the year in which you live. And we have to pursue our freedom in the year in which we live. Stop using these 1960s outdated strategies that the enemy has been knowing about and been aware of since the 1960s. He broke up those strategies in the 1960s, and we still running them today, and we wonder why we can't make no progress. We're still talking about voting. Let me just say this real quick, because it was really at the top of the hour. Let me say this real quick, brothers and sisters. Don't believe nothing that is fed to the masses of the people. They want to say, if you don't vote, you can't complain. That's a lie. See, that's that 85% propaganda to deceive people. And we deceive each other out of ignorance. They deceive us intentionally. We deceive each other out of ignorance because we just repeat what the master says. Those Negroes that's saying that are ones that's trying to get your vote so they can get in privileged position close to the master so they can think they equal to the master, and they're part of the master deception. See, one thing about winning at the money game, brothers and sisters, you don't lie. You don't lie to yourself. You don't participate in a lie. You're not tricked and fooled by a lie. And you recognize a lie when it's coming. So here's the point. They say you can't, if you don't vote, you can't complain. That's a lie. If I spend my money in America, I can complain. If I spend my money with Walmart, I can complain. If I spend my money in the taxpayers, and it goes to these politicians through taxes that I pay, sales taxes and gas taxes and property taxes and all those other taxes that these politicians are being paid their salary on, then I can complain. I don't have to vote. I'm paying with my money. I'm spending my money. I can complain. So don't believe that hype. Don't let them lie to you. If you don't vote, you can't complain. Hell yeah, I can complain. I'm spending my money. And you taking my money. I can complain. It's like the mafia. You take their money. Right? You owe them because you take their money. You don't owe them because you took their vote. Welcome to America, brothers and sisters. America's about the money game. Ain't no other game is being played here in America but the money game. And you have winners and you have losers. And those who win, really win. Not give you the facade of winning. Not window dress winning. But really win. Those that accumulate hard assets. Gold, silver, land. Businesses. Those are the ones who play by the rules to win and plan to keep. As our brother Robert says here in Houston, white folks play to keep and we just keep on playing. So with that being said, brothers and sisters, go to DarylMuhammad.net. Subscribe there. We'll see you this Sunday at 7:30 for a meet and greet. And remember, financial freedom or freedom is not free. All right. To all my detractors, it's on, brothers and sisters. No time for cowards. Cowards are the first one to get slaughtered in battle because they don't know what direction to go in. So that being said, we'll see you at the top, not from the top, because you, your family, but most importantly, our black community. Hashtag black dollars, hashtag black wealth, hashtag black economy. Our black community deserves fearless, uncompromising, unapologetic people who are seeking freedom of all kind. They need your very best, brothers and sisters. So go out and be your very best. All right, so until Saturday for some, and Monday for most, take care and God bless. All right, Meerkat. All right, hopefully you guys like that. What's up? It's Gotta Be Junior. Appreciate you for restreaming Chorizo, thank you for restreaming. I appreciate you there. And of course, Landing Point, really, really appreciate you. And also Living Chic. Thank you so very much, you guys, for being here. And like I said, I'll see some of you guys on Saturday on the meetup conference call. And the rest, I'll see you Monday, God willing. All right? So take care. God bless.